still signing deals. Still, after all they done stole. What's up? It's your girl, Coach T. Taryn, like Karen, but with a T. Spelled just a little differently for those of you who don't know me. Are you a Jay-Z and Beyonce fan? Were you a huge fan of the 444 album? That joint was dope. I just have to tell you, I was skeptical. I was a pessimist when I originally heard the album. I just wanted to kind of come on here and state my opinion, because I do have one about the whole entire album, but particularly one song. I was a pessimist. All right, I didn't really want to hear it. It took me probably a whole month and a half before I actually heard the album. And Beyonce had made an album, you know, her last album, I didn't care for. I didn't know where she was going. She is Queen B. I agree. That girl, hey, she does it, but the last couple albums wasn't my zhush. I couldn't really stand.
I don't know if I really want to listen to, you know, the new Jay-Z album.
I had no idea this man was spitting true stuff. But the point I wanted to
take a snippet of this because I was a little hurt by some of the reactions that I had been hearing about this album, the 444 album. Now, why I'm so hype and ecstatic about it, first and foremost, I'm heavy on wanting wealth. I want wealth creation. I believe in multiple sources of income. I don't rely on just one. I quit my 9-to-5. AT&T, a little backstory about that. AT&T messed up my check, cut short of me $400, which put me in a bind. This was a series of just messings up of jobs that I had, which was my last straw. And I told myself that was going to be the last job I let be responsible for cutting me a check. So I quit. I no longer work there. I am an entrepreneur full time. And I love it. Okay. So that fired me up when I heard the album was all about black entrepreneurship. And I said, oh my gosh, T. It was awesome. It was awesome. I absolutely loved it. I loved it. But here was the discouraging part is that the response that I got from the album wasn't the same response that other people got from the album, and I was heartbroken. 50 Cent said that the album sounded like golf course music.
I ain't gonna hold you up, son. That shit was like golf course music.
Hold on. Literally? Too smart?
Good girl.
And I was upset by
that because now I used to golf, okay? I'm no tiger. I can't even name a female golfer. But when I was golfing, they wasn't playing that on the golf course. So that upset me that other people, mainstream who are artists, have a platform to speak good to our people.
And I deny the fact that the African American community is definitely lacking in tools to be successful. And that's just the story. That's just what happened. Starting all the way from slavery, that's how we were ingrained. And understand, there's no pity party here, because I definitely understand there are people who are just lazy just because. But the way that we were conditioned, and the community doesn't understand that there's more out there. Anyway, I was discouraged that these artists have a platform and didn't see that Jay-Z could possibly be the start of changing the hip-hop world and bringing black entrepreneurship to light, okay? So something that I just wanted to take, because I love the song Moonlight, all right? I love the song Moonlight. And I wanted to take a verse that they speak of, and kind of break that down as to my review of that and what I got out of that. And hopefully you understand the analogy that he was trying to make. I mean, this man was genius. So he says, y'all niggas still signing deals, still, after all they done stole for real. Okay, now let me stop right there, because this is what I get. But I think that we all hear music differently, and we internalize it differently. So here is my take on what this means. So y'all still signing deals, still, after all they done stole for real. I immediately thought, wow, people are still out here looking for a second, third, fourth job, okay? And my whole thing is, I want to work for myself. I don't believe in having a 9-to-5. I believe a 9-to-5 is a form of gaining income, but it's not a form of wealth creation. You cannot get rich off of a job, and you need to learn wealth creation, all right? So I see on Facebook a lot, I am an online marketer, digital nomad, affiliate marketer, whatever you want to call it, and I see a lot of people wanting jobs. People talk to me that I give them work from home jobs and things like that. to try to fire their boss so that they can leave that garbage, okay? But all day long I hear, hey, you know who's hiring? I need a second job. I mean, the struggle's real. Scroll your timeline. Right now, I bet you can find some people that are struggling and wanting another job. But my thing is, why are we still trying to get another job, allowing other people to still be in control of our money, of our check? Why are we still doing the same thing when we know the system doesn't work? So I've been on both sides of the spectrum. And it doesn't matter whether you're making $40 a sale, making $1,500 a week, or $560 a week. You're still going to struggle in some way, shape, or form the way that the economy is changing, okay? And so my whole thing is, I believe that the person can do more. You can do more. I'm going to speak to you. You can do more than what you think you can. And you don't have to be, you don't have to allow someone else to be in charge of giving you something. Giving you a job, giving you vacation time, giving you sick days off, giving you the okay to go see your kids' games or to go to a PTA meeting, like literally simple stuff like that. So you guys are still looking for jobs after all they done stole. Taxes take a lot of your money, 20 to 24% depending on the tax bracket. Now, when I was making $1,500 a week, I was literally getting $400 taken off the top. Every time, the lower I make, you know, that dwindles again. I make $560 a week. They're gonna take 24% of that. It's gonna leave me with about $300 to $350. And you can check me on my math because I was a D, C, D student in math. Okay, but anyways, it's pointless to do that. Like these jobs are literally stealing from you. If you're trying to tell me that, okay, you, another grown person is trying to tell me, who's a grown person, that I can only take X amount of days off, that I can only go to the bathroom at this time, I can only eat lunch at this time for this amount of time. They're stealing from you. And then you take taxes all the time. I work those hours. I put the time in for those hours, and you gonna take that? They're stealing from you. And it doesn't have to be that way. Okay, after all they'd done to all Lauryn Hill. Now, from my research, what they did to Lauryn Hill was, I love Lauryn Hill, okay? She had a baby, or she was pregnant, and the industry wanted her to abort the baby, and she didn't want to do that, and she was basically blackballed from the industry. I did not know that. Did you know that? I thought, she's with the Fijis, Wyclef John. And I just thought maybe they took a break. I'm 25, all right? So my mom used to bump to the Fijis. Lord Jesus, please don't laugh at me. But I used to have karaoke, strumming my pain. So I know a little bit about Lauryn Hill, but I noticed that she wasn't relevant on the scene. The last big thing was the BET Awards. The BET Awards, when she went out there, she had on that bow to the side, and it was all of them, the whole group. And everybody talked about this as a big deal, that they were coming back. Where she had been, I didn't know. I just literally thought they had took a break. She was blackballed. She was blackballed because she wanted to have a baby. And the infamous they, the people who call the shots, I always say, instead of making the shots, you want to be calling them because they run it. Seriously. They blackballed her literally because she didn't want to abort her baby. Shout out to her, because I don't really believe in abortions unless there's an extreme case like rape, incest, and things like that. So, but that's crazy. That's crazy. And then he goes on to say after that, and y'all niggas is supposed to be trill. So y'all supposed to be hood. Y'all supposed to be hard. Y'all supposed to be like, I get my own type of money. But y'all still going to get another grown person to sign your check. They stealing from you. And they're stealing from a lot of the people in the industry. Why are these people so mainstream, yet they're so broke? So broke. Toni Braxton, everybody thought that Toni Braxton had spent all her money. That wasn't the case. Contracts and things aren't right. They are stealing. Just like 9-to-5s are stealing from you. All right? What else you didn't say? And that's real talk when you behind on your taxes and you pawn all your chains and they run off with your masters. Okay, so you giving them everything. You giving them your work. You giving them your dedication. You giving them your blood, sweat, and tears. They still stealing from you. And when you get behind on your taxes, they don't care. When you get behind on your bills and your light bills due, can you get an advance? Now, some jobs will give you an advance. My wife works for a company, and I don't like many companies, but her company is awesome, seriously. And they can advance her a check.
And then he goes on and he says,
and they run off with your masters and took us to the Beverly Hills while we're in Calabasas, and my head is scratching because that shit is backwards. That shit ain't right. And it's not. It's not. It's not right, you know? You give them your blood, sweat, tears, and then when you need time off for an emergency, you gotta be approved. You need time off because you're literally dying sick and don't want to make the whole office contagious. You gotta get approved. Like, that ain't right. That's not right. That's not right. And in my head scratches at a lot of these jobs. I worked as a debt collector for student loans. Yeah. So my bounce back game is strong. All the hoopla you get, all the cursing out you get, all the negativity you get. Man, being a debt collector can be extremely exhausting.
And
I had hit bonus 1 month of $5,000. I mean, this month of everything that I made, including my bonuses, I was literally bringing in almost close to $7,000. Okay, would have been the most that I ever brought home at 23 years old. So I was doing pretty well for myself. Now, the interesting part about this, though, No one in the building could actually figure out their commission, all right? The way that it works, and that's another thing too. When you can't figure out what your commission is, it's all these different metrics and all these different formulas you gotta do. Like I said, I was a CD student in math. I don't have time to be plugging in these different X's and Y's to figure out what my check is. So I would just, we would just wait for the slip. So me and my wife worked together. Me and my wife have worked at a lot of jobs together, commission-based, because we like to double up on that money. So what happened was I signed a bonus of over $5,000. So don't you know, when the time comes for me to get that $5,000, it wasn't $5,000, it was $3,000. And then it had nothing to do with taxes. Instead of over $5,000, somebody messed something up. So I got $3,000. Yeah. Stealing from me. Nobody could explain where the mess up was. And this stuff would happen frequently. Of course, that's why I'm not there anymore. And I always feel like companies are going to find out. Companies are in the business to make money, guys. They're in the business to make money. So the cheaper that you cost to them is great in their book, because they care about the customer more than they care about the employee. If you cost more than the customer, it's a problem. Now, it shouldn't be like that, but that's how it is. That's the truth. That's the reality. Companies still have missions and core values and statements on the board that they say that they go by and they live by, but that's not the case. All right, so just think about that. Jay-Z, man, this album was absolutely fire. It got me fired up. It improved my marriage. Man can't be rich if he can't take care of his family. All right, it fired me up for a better marriage. It fired me up to want more. It fired me, and I already want more, but it fired me up to keep pushing. It fired me up to be like, you know what? The African-American community needs to stop making excuses all the time about why we can't get ahead, because in 2017, if from now until, nobody's going to hold us back aside from us. So what were your thoughts on the Jay-Z 444 album? Because I thought that stuff was fire. I love that album. What was your favorite song? What did you think of it when it relates to entrepreneurship and black entrepreneurship and capitalism and just investing in yourself? Like, literally talks about this great, great stuff. So I want to know what you thought. I appreciate you watching this video. Make sure you give it a thumbs up. Make sure you subscribe to my channel, and I'll come back with some more heat, some more fire, some more great videos for you. Peace out.